So to reiterate, what happens in the chain of gross touch, pain, and temperature sensations reaching the brain, I want to use this as a blank, and for you to use this hopefully as a blank to practice drawing this pathway. So I'm going to draw it, and if you've printed this, you can draw along with me, and we'll start with, let's see, here we go. Here's a hot mug of coffee. Steam, steam. And here's your hand. Sort of. I'm not the artist, okay? So, hot, cold, temperature, whatever it is, pain, if this is really hot, there are receptors in your skin that are connected to a dorsal root ganglion neuron, which then sends that information into the dorsal horn, okay? So this is number one neuron in the chain. I like to think of it as a relay race. So you've got the neuron one picks up the baton, which is the signal from whatever sensation's out here, and relays it to neuron number two, which is in the dorsal horn. Gray matter. Okay, the dorsal horn neuron then picks up that information at the appropriate level, so don't worry about where I'm drawing the levels in. That axon crosses the midline, okay? It's going to cross the midline and go all the way up to the thalamus. It crosses, where it crosses the midline, we call it the ventral white commissure. And this tract within the white matter of the spinal cord, where it is ascending, is called the anterolateral system. The ALS then is present at all levels of the spinal cord, as are, you know, DRG are present at all levels, and gray matter is present at all levels. So that's the second neuron. Neuron number three is in the thalamus. Neuron number three gets information from neuron number two, and it projects to the post-central gyrus, and that is where gross touch, pain, and temperature come to perception. It's where you actually notice that the mug is hot. The next section, the next slide, has this a little more simplified, which is something I drew, so you know it's going to be simple. So here we go. In this slide, what you can see is, again, we have a stimulus somewhere in the periphery, which is picked up by the dorsal root ganglion neuron, which then synapses on a neuron within the dorsal horn. The axon of this neuron crosses the midline, ascends in the anterolateral system, synapses on neuron number three, which then ascends to the sensory cortex, where that sensation comes to perception. So I hope that the combination of these two different types of drawings and diagrams can help you understand how gross touch, pain, and temperature are relayed from the periphery to the central nervous system. And you're going to ask, well, why do I need to know this? Well, because fine touch is different. And we'll talk about that in the next section. And so to summarize, what I want you to know is how many neurons does it take to relay gross touch, pain, and temperature from the periphery to the primary sensory cortex? Where are these neurons located? The axon of which neuron in the chain crosses the midline? Where does this axon cross the midline? And then where does this axon travel as it ascends towards the brain, i.e. what area of the spinal cord, what is the name of that tract where this axon travels as it's headed toward the brain? If you know this, you're going to be ready for the assessment.